that the gifts that's in us,
thank you, Lord,
that you have placed by the power of the Holy Spirit,
yes, yes,
to serve this present age,
thank you, Jesus,
our calling to fulfill.
Oh, yes.
That we would be stirred up.
Thank you.
That our passions and our fire for you would be stirred up.
Yes.
By the living, breathing word of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I thank you, Father, that this city.
Yeah.
That this state.
Yes.
And that this country.
Yes, Lord.
And this world.
Yes.
Will be impacted.
Thank you, Jesus.
By
yes.
That in which we hear tonight.
Yes, now, Lord. Yeah.
Father, we thank you. We thank you for the expanse of your kingdom.
Yes, Father.
We thank you for the largeness of your word.
Yes, Father. Yes.
We thank you for the globalization of
thank
the
you,
gospel
Jesus.
Of Jesus Christ. Evangelism is our support.
Yes, it is.
Knowing God and making him known. And we do give you
thank
glory
you,
and honor for the privilege
yeah.
to serve our generation.
Thank you, Jesus.
The good news of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, forgive us for any area that we have been apathetic, or that we have been neglectful or dismissive of this major task
oh,
and
Jesus.
Assignment.
Yes, Lord.
And we thank you for the precious blood of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Washing us now.
Yeah.
And stirring us by the washing of the water.
Yeah, Lord.
And we do give you glory.
Thank
glory.
You, Jesus.
Every soul that shall be saved.
Oh, yeah.
Every body that shall be healed.
Oh, Jesus.
Every mind that shall be delivered.
Thank you, Lord.
Every life that shall be set free.
Yes.
By the preaching of the gospel
yes.
of Jesus Christ.
Yes, Lord.
That it is still the power
oh,
of God
thank you, Father.
To salvation.
Yes, Father.
To everyone that believes. And we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name. And the people said, amen.
Amen.
Praise God. You may be seated in his presence. Praise the name of our God. Excited about what God is going to do and say. And you know what occurred to me? You know, sometimes truth can be right in front of you and you don't even know it.
Right.
Yeah.
And so I was thinking, thank you so much, son. Would y'all give the drummer some?
Yeah.
Run into another gig, but we thank God for him. Amen. And thank God for Pastor Chris.
Yeah.
Amen. I said, Pastor Chris, I want it hot tonight.
Hey.
He gave it to me red hot.
All right.
What a great team. My niece is here tonight. Amen. My singing niece, preaching niece. I'm just excited about what God is doing. And Nancy Early is called. I thought I was going to have to go to AT&T and do a drive-by. I said, nah, I'm buying that demon. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So glad for everyone that is here tonight. God is good. All right. So, I'm thinking in my mind as I'm studying, we're going to continue our lesson on world evangelism, global evangelism. Evangelism is our supreme task, and it is also the heartbeat of God. And so as I was putting this all together tonight for the lesson, and I got to thinking, why not just teach my class on evangelism that I teach in the seminary?
Okay, all right.
Why not?
All right.
And I'm like, I couldn't have a VA. I've taught this class in the college and seminary level, and so I just went back to some of my notes and pulled up some syllabus information. I said, well, why not just start now and begin to teach the 16-week class on global evangelism. So are y'all ready? Y'all get y'all game?
16 weeks.
Is that good
16
for y'all?
Weeks.
Does that sound like a win?
All right.
Like a two-time.
I was like, that's easy. So we're going to talk a little bit about evangelism and what that means. And we believe that evangelism is our supreme task.
Yes.
And so simply put, take out something to write with something to write off. Evangelism is simply knowing God and making him known.
Yes, Lord.
That's the simple definition of evangelism. It's most simplistic down to the common denominator of what is evangelism. Because people can go out and say, well, you know, it's winning souls, amen, and somebody can say, well, it's getting people saved, and somebody else may say, well, it's getting people baptized, and other people may say, it's getting people to join the church. And it's all of those things inclusively. But ultimately, for a working definition for our class, we're going to make it simple. What is evangelism? It is simply knowing God and making him known.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. So since we're going to be in class for the next 16 or so weeks, mm-hmm. you want to bring your pencils and bring your papers and get in the mindset of really, really mm-hmm. studying and really learning what this really means. There is a science to this. There is some applied principles that we want to get into. And as we go through the class, we don't want to be random about it. I want you to really see systematically how God lays this out for us and what an awesome, awesome responsibility it is for those of us that are saved, that we must win souls.
Amen.
And the church has gotten so far away from that being a mandate
mm-hmm.
that it's no longer the priority. It's no longer talked about. It's no longer taught on. It's no longer, you know, emphasized. It's no longer celebrated in terms of people bringing others to Christ. So it just kind of gets lost in the songs. And when you lose focus on evangelism, then you start majoring in minor things.
Mm.
Wow. That's good.
You start majoring in ministry.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You start making ministry a priority. Start making your calling more important. You start pimping, if you will, hustling your gifts, your talents. All really points back to self-indulgence and not evangelism. There is a lady that's on television. She has that food show in St. Louis, I believe it is. And she says, if it don't make money, it don't make sense. What's her name? Sweetie Pie. You know Ruthie, no, right? The chef among us. So Sweetie Pie, she said, if it don't make money, I had a beautiful opportunity to meet her in California this year. Wonderful young woman of God, who has just been cooking all her life. And just all of a sudden got discovered and made a hit on the overall network. Now she's a movie star, just cooking. But the drive behind what she does is money.
Mm-hmm.
And so for her, doesn't make money, it doesn't make sense. So right. I want to take a piece of that, it don't make sense. And I want to put what I believe is the message of Christ to us. If you don't win souls, it don't make sense.
Yes.
Don't win souls, it don't make sense. If the preaching of the gospel is not winning souls, if the songs we sing, times that we gather, not to equip us, to go back out and win souls, then it don't make sense. If our programming doesn't win souls, then it don't make sense.
Mm-hmm.
If anything that we are doing, even in our careers, in our marketplace presence, don't win souls, it don't make sense. Now, you got to see how those things began to interact with each other. If you really understand that where you go every day and the ability to go there is simply because God needs you to go, and that there's somebody there that needs to hear the gospel, even on your jobs that you go to every day, even when you go to the grocery store, when you are getting your car washed, if we can get this in our minds every day, that at the end of the day, everything I've done was for the intent and purpose
of
knowing God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Wow.
Then everything in our life would change.
Yes.
Because what it does is it changes the context of what you're doing. Mm-hmm. So I go to work thinking that I'm just going to pay bills. I go to work thinking that this is a way for me to move ahead in life, to accomplish certain things, buy a house, pay my car note. But if you change that and understand that as a believer in Jesus Christ, as a spirit-filled, born again, amen, man or woman of God,
yes, that Lord,
whatever you do, if it don't win something,
right,
it don't make sense.
Hey.
If I'm driving a school bus,
yes,
somebody on the bus needs to be saved.
Come on, yeah.
Somebody at the terminal needs,
yes,
to be,
yes, yes.
If I'm a nurse on the floor, somebody needs to be saved.
Yeah.
If I'm a social worker, well, somebody needs to be saved.
Yeah.
If I'm doing hair, if I'm washing clothes, if I'm mopping floors, if I'm typing letters,
yes,
that wherever I go,
hallelujah,
that evangelist,
yeah,
is my supreme thing.
Amen.
It is the reason I live, the reason,
yes,
I breathe.
Yes.
And so if we can change,
yes, Father,
our minds,
yes, minds,
about what it is, mm-hmm, that we are alive,
yeah,
for, change your mind about that. And instead of evangelism being optional, to make it mandatory.
Thank you, Lord.
Instead of it being casual or by accident, or, yeah, you know, I just got to talk to somebody and, you know, church came up and, you know, no, to be more intentional. Not waiting for it to come up, but bring it up. To put it in the forefront of everything you do. To make sure that even when you are engaging others that may be of other faiths or other cultures, or whatever it is that you do, and however many people that you have to engage in your everyday walk, that you understand that the whole world needs Jesus.
Amen. Yeah.
It does not matter that they're different than you, or that they may already be in some form of religion. That you cannot allow that to cause you to be silent.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we're not selling Christianity.
Right.
We're selling Christ.
Right.
We're selling Jesus Christ.
Yes.
So we're not trying to get people to become Christians. We want people to go to heaven.
Yes.
We want people to know Christ. So that at the end of the end of the end of their life, that they will see God in peace.
Yes, Lord.
If you get that in your mind, if somehow these next few weeks we can change the paradigm of our thinking.
Yes.
And our mode of operations.
Yes.
I believe that we'll begin to see souls.
Amen.
Come to Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
So, I want you to go to Matthew chapter number 6.
Matthew 6.
For just a minute. Matthew chapter number 6. And let's establish a framework. Amen. Matthew chapter number 6. Real familiar passage of scripture. You probably could repeat it without even turning to it. You know what I love about the Word of God? No matter how many times I've read it, it's always fresh.
Mm-hmm.
It's always good. Amen.
Amen.
So, verse 33, and we all know it, so let's read it together. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will shall be added unto you. So imagine that the kingdom was first priority in our lives. And that's why on Sunday we're teaching on being born again.
Mm.
Because being born again means that the kingdom of God, God's economy, God's context, God's infrastructure, God's sovereignty, everything that has to do with God is a first priority in your life. So imagine if that's really true, that the kingdom and the king first in your life. Now the reality is, it's not. The reality is that it's just not. Somewhere along life's journey, the kingdom and the king have lost their top spot in our lives.
Wow.
And we have become overrun with life on this planet and all that it takes for us to be comfortable or to be successful or to somehow live in a place where we are content. So the kingdom is not first. So we got to change that. In the time that we'll spend here, that's got to change. And the first thing that's got to change is that we have to repent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That the king is not first.
Yes.
That the kingdom is not first. And it doesn't matter what else is first. It doesn't matter. We all will, based on our life and based on our upbringing and our environments, etc. Some people say family is first. Some people say, you know, my job is first, or, you know, different things. We all have different things that we want to make first. But God is very clear to us. Jesus is very clear. The kingdom of God is at hand. People, we're going to die. We're going to leave this earth.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to leave this earth. And our works will follow us.
Yes.
When we leave this earth, our works will follow us. Our bank accounts will not follow us.
Right.
Our families will not follow us. Our jobs and careers will not follow us. Our degrees will not follow us. Our lovers won't follow us. Let me just throw that all in. Just throw it all in. Amen. Our marriages won't even follow us.
Amen.
Our relationships will not follow us.
Right.
Nothing that we have done on this earth will follow us except what we've done for Christ.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. You know, Lois here, Bass, and they know all those old songs. Only what you do for Christ is going to last.
Yeah.
Wow.
And just measure that right now in terms of if you were to be called home right now.
Right now.
Tonight.
Right now.
If we were in that place where our souls were required of us tonight.
Mm.
See, that's the reality.
Amen.
You know, in most of these contemporary songs, they do away with heaven. Yeah. The old hymns have heaven in it.
Right.
Every other verse.
Right.
Because going to heaven was the goal.
Yes.
One day we're going to go see Jesus.
One day.
Right. Amen. So the contemporary songs focus on you. The old songs focus on him.
Yes.
And the goal, the reward of our faith, the reward of our salvation, is that we're going to see Jesus Christ.
Right.
Yeah. And so over the years of our being in church, heaven is no longer a problem. Seeing God is no longer a problem. Dying is no longer a problem. The old saints couldn't wait to die.
Right. Right. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
It's like, honey, I'm going to see Jesus. They was like, they was fine. Whatever.
Right now.
Right now. My mom raised us up saying it every day, almost. Every week. Y'all will miss me when I'm gone. One day I'm going to see Jesus. My kind master.
Hey.
I'm going to go.
Yeah.
And they long for it. They long to see Jesus.
Right.
They long to see him.
Yes.
And to be in heaven and in his presence.
Hallelujah.
Their salvation was a priority in their lives. They knew, and you heard songs like, "This old world is not my home."
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Glory to God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. I'm just a poor pilgrim.
Uh-huh.
I'm all traveling through a barren.
Yeah.
Glory to God. We all get to heaven.
Yes.
On a day of rejoicing.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes. Oh, they tell me of an uncounted thing.
Yeah.
Some glad morning when this life is over.
Oh. Hallelujah.
It's what they wanted.
Yes.
At the end of life, was I'm going to see Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When I see Jesus.
Yeah.
When I see Jesus,
woo!
I see the man that died for me.
Yeah.
When I see the man that set me free.
Hey.
Don't talk like that no more.
Right. Oh. Right.
Christian folks.
We've been lost.
Yes.
Seeing Christ. start the work of their faith.
Yes.
Because they knew that they had to give an account.
Yes.
And they wanted their works to follow.
Mm-hmm.
A charge to keep ahead.
Yeah.
A heart to glorify.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
I ever died and sold the safe.
Yeah.
And fitted for the soul.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When we've been there 10,000 years.
All right.
Bright shining as the sun.
Yes.
No less days to sing his praise.
Yes.
Than when we first began. Right. Those songs.
Yeah.
Had value.
Right.
And weight. Because they looked forward.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
I'm telling you, y'all all lift your hands and say, God, put that back in.
Yeah.
Soon and very soon.
Yeah, yeah.
Going to see the king.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. No more dying.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to see the king.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
No more crying then.
Woo.
I'm going to see the king.
Hallelujah.
Then they say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
I'm going to see the king.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Should there be any mountains I can't cross? Woo. Listen, it don't matter.
Yeah.
It don't matter.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
Don't matter.
This life is going to pass me by.
Right.
I'm going to see the king.
What a day that will be.
Woo. Hallelujah.
Hey.
When we lost the message of the gospel.
Yes.
We lost the priority of the kingdom of God.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's going to slide down.
Amen.
Replace it with so many things that don't have anything to do with Jesus.
Right.
It has to do with us. Listen to most of these songs. All these contemporary songs, a lot of them have to do with us.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a friend of God. It's all about me. Everything is all about me. Humanism. Mm. Has slipped in. The songs don't even have Jesus in it. You gotta figure out who you're talking to. You can sing it in a Muslim, you can sing it in a mosque.
Yeah.
You can sing it somewhere else in the Catholic church, you can sing it because you don't have Jesus in it.
Right.
So you just figure it out. You can sing it at the bar, at the club. Or right down in the Southern Fires and sing it. Nobody knows.
You're hitting it, Bishop.
It's true.
Because it's no longer the goal.
Mm-hmm.
We dread. They clung to.
Right.
I want to see the king. I want to see Jesus. Mm-hmm. My mother called him her kind master.
Ah, hallelujah.
Kind master.
Yes, Lord.
She was so excited. And I should say,
wow.
And she had already told me about a year before. I take it, ready to go. Don't you pray. Those are her exact words right across that street. Don't you pray. Take care of Ruth because you know Ruth. Why she's
going to
cry. She said, if you don't you pray. And I said, are you serious? She said, yes, because if you pray, I'm going to have to come back. About a year later, she looked me in my face. Their dwelling place. Woo! Glory to God.
Hey.
She went on up out of here. When the angels came and got her, the room filled up. The glory of the Lord. I told Ruth, I said, get out of here. Go call everybody. Mama gone. And I had the privilege of looking. When she opened her eyes, she looked in that corner. When I looked up, I said, Mama, who you see? I began to sing in her ear her favorite hymn. Not pass me by.
Mm.
And she went to go. And I saw her spirit come up out of her body. And I saw when it went up out of her mouth. And I saw when her spirit literally, when her spirit man lifted up and went into that corner where I couldn't see her no more. And then that body went.
Amen.
Woo.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's it.
Thank you.
Fear in the room. Wasn't no dread in the room. Wasn't no darkness in the room. Wasn't none of that.
Right.
She went to see her kind.
Hallelujah.
Woo, she wanted to see.
Yeah.
She was waiting to see.
Hey.
Some of us go now, we ain't got work to go with. Ain't got an apple to go with.
Amen. Wow.
Ain't got an arm. Ain't got a chestnut.
Wow.
Roasting on the open fire. Ain't got a soul to go with you.
Wow.
Ain't got no sheaves to carry.
Oh, Lord.
Ain't want nobody to go.
Wow.
Amen.
Woo. Ooh, Lord.
Amen.
That ought to be your goal.
Yes.
That they that die in the Lord, when they die in the Lord, their works do follow.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Just save me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Save.
Hallelujah.
Save me, God.
Yeah.
Save me.
Save me.
You try to be apostles and prophets. That thing don't have no value in others. These people, you lead to salvation.
Yes, yes.
In Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Those are the works that will follow us.
Yeah. Yeah.
Those are the words.
Those are the rewards. The rewards are not going to come because you sang songs and ushered at the door.
Right.
I know.
I mean, how many people did you tell about this Jesus?
Yes.
How many people came to a saving knowledge of Jesus Christ
because
of you?
Yes. Yes.
What is first? And why is it first? How long has it been first? My mother told me one time, she said, Daddy, something you got to do by yourself. I said, Mama, you got to do that by yourself. Can't nobody do that with you.
Amen.
Somebody can't, they can't stay in prophecy.
Mm-hmm.
You have to do it for yourself. I don't want my stuff to be burned up. I don't want to bury sin. They say, and you ain't got nothing. All your stuff all burned up because it was nothing. Church work and church performance, church duties, and church assignments,
right,
and church responsibilities.
Right.
Not one soul. Can you imagine standing in front of the Lord?
No, no.
And you've been saved since you was a child, and you ain't let nobody to the Lord.
Wow.
What you think he gonna say to you?
Wow.
I mean, just really for real, what lie have you told yourself?
Yeah. Say, who are you?
Woo!
Just right there.
Who are you?
Think about it.
Yeah.
Because the moment that you leave this body, you are present with the Lord.
Right.
And at that
right.
Right there, standing before him, is the bema seat of Christ.
Mm.
And all of us will give an account of what we have done in this body.
Yes.
The deeds and the words.
Yes.
And can you imagine standing there before the Lord, say you're 100 years old, and you got saved at 10, and you don't have nobody saved?
Nobody.
Woo!
Wow.
What are you going to say? What lie do you think you're going to be able to pass off at that moment? As to why you want nobody to.
Jesus.
You think he's going to ask you about how many churches you planted? No. How many songs did you write? No.
Right.
How many sermons did you preach? No. He's going to ask you, where are your works?
Right.
And he opened the books. Your name is in the book of life. But then he gonna open the books of your works.
Mm.
You may say have not one, but two people to Jesus.